Hello and welcome back to our yoga home. My name is Lata, or also known as Beach Yoga Emotion. This class today is 30 minutes long and it's a slow flow class, focusing mostly on opening the parts of your heart and shoulders. So the only thing you need is a mat, a block, and the most important thing, yourself. So let's get started. A blanket underneath your knees or your heels and sit down like this. Or you can also use a block sliding in between your feet and sit down just like this. Okay? Great. If that is not accessible for you, don't worry, choose either a seated position where you can sit for a minute or so in this pose. Let's close our eyes here. And let's take a deep inhale through the nose. And a deep exhale out through the mouth. Inhale. Deep through the nose, chest, belly. Exhale out. And last one, inhale through the nose and exhale out. Take a little moment, notice your body, notice your breath. And then from here, slowly, slowly open your eyes. And from here, reach your hands forward, interlace your fingers and press your palms towards me. From here, reach your hands up towards the ceiling. Follow your gaze up towards your fingertips. And on your exhale, you push the hands forward to draw your navel in. Inhale, reach your hands up. And exhale, push forward. Also feel how your shoulder blades separate when here in this pose. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, lower down. Two more, inhale, reach, make yourself long. And exhale, out. Inhale, reach long, release your hands and reach them all the way back until you interlace the fingers in the back. You can have your elbows bent or your arms straight, but keep squeezing your palms together. Okay, inhale here and maybe separate your hands a little bit further away from your back, doing the best in your ability, keeping the belly in, so I'm not coming here to lower, dumping into lower back, navel in, try to relax your shoulders, squeeze your palms here together. Take a deep inhale through the nose into chest and belly. And exhale it out. Another one just like this. Inhale deep. And exhale, release. From here, let's remove the block. Come on all four. If you like, you can tap your feet a little bit here to be seated. In this pose is quite funny for the feet, so feel free to move them here. Okay, that's it. Your hands are right underneath your shoulders, knees right underneath your hips, and your fingers are spread wide open. Grip the mat from here, draw your navel in, and separate your shoulder blades. From here, you reach your left foot towards the back, your right hand forward, and then squeeze your elbow towards your knee. Inhale long, exhale, squeeze, and inhale long here and bend your knee and reach with your right hand all the way across and hold on to your left foot. If you don't reach, you can also use a strap here and then kick into your left foot. Take a breath here, in and out. Last one. And release. Let's do the same on the opposite side. Your right heel pushing back and your left hand reaching forward. On your exhale, squeeze elbow, knee together. Inhale, reach long. And exhale, squeeze it in. And last one, inhale, reach, bend your knee, and reach all the way across, reach towards your left foot, kick it in here, breathe, hold, last breath in, kick a little more, and last breath out, release from here. You can walk your knees a little bit more back, and then chest comes down onto the mat and lay down onto your belly. From here, reach your hands back onto both sides and gaze towards your mat. If you like, you can still keep your forehead down onto the mat. And we start by lifting up the feet. Lift your feet and thighs off the ground, and lower down, and lift the feet, lift the thighs, and lower down. Next one, we go for feet up, thighs up, and hands also reaching up. Chest is reaching up, and you gaze towards the mat, so your neck is long. Squeeze your inner thighs together and exhale low. We'll repeat two times more. Inhale, reach. And exhale, release. Last one. Inhale, reach up. Hands are up, pulling towards the back. Keep holding here. Lift the chest a little higher. Reach your thighs a little higher, squeezing your thighs together. Breathe and release. Take a little moment here. Hands right next to your body. You can gaze towards one side. And notice your back muscles here. Already nice and warm. And then from here, both hands come forward. You bend your right knee, and with your right hand, you reach towards your right foot. Kick it in here into your right foot, and your left hand, just your fingertips are down onto the mat. Reach forward, maybe lift your chest a little higher. Don't just press with your hand here into the mat. Rather, try to use your muscles in the back to lift you up. And also your right foot and right hand kicking into each other. And exhale, release. And we switch this side. Right hand comes down. Left hand reaches towards your left foot. Gaze down towards the mat. And kick into this left foot. Left foot kicking into your left hand. Breathe, hold, and another breath in, another breath out. Last inhale and exhale, lower down. Take a little moment here. Notice your back muscles will work. So nice. And then get your hands right underneath your shoulders and push back on all four. Tap your toes and come into your down dog. Down dog. If you like, you can pedal out your legs here a little bit. If you need to, or just press your heels towards the mat. Inner rotate your arms. So your shoulders get a little bit further away from your ears. From here, bend your knees and start making your way all the way to the top. Your feet are as wide as your hip. Bend your knees slightly and let your upper body just sink down towards the mat. If you like, you can even have your hands on to a block. Or if you like, just hold on to your opposite elbows. Relax your neck and your shoulders a little bit more. And then from here, sink your hip low, release your elbows, and reach your hands back. I'm looking here just like this skiing guys, going down the slope. Interlace the fingers in the back. Also here, you can have your elbows bent or arms straight, but keep squeezing your palms together. And then from here, reach your glutes back up. And get your hands again further away from your back. Don't worry, it can be less than it's right now here for me, but if you're more open in the parts of your shoulders, it might also be more. So you go for what is accessible for you, what also feels good in your body, without force, without pain. Try to relax with each exhale, your shoulders a little bit more, but keep squeezing your palms together. Palms squeezing together. Bend elbows, straight arms, you choose, but keep your palms squeezing together. And from here, sit back down and reach your hands down, reach your hands up, push through your heels. Come into a standing pose. Very nice. Here we are. Step your feet together so your big toes touch. And from here, bend your knees and sit back down into your chair. Slide over your mat with your fingertips and reach up. Palms touch. Navel in. And on your exhale, bend over. Inhale, halfway lift. And from here, we start with the right foot. Your right foot takes a big step back. Your knee comes down. You reach your hand up. Draw your navel in and squeeze your right glute here. Exhale, hands come down, you tug your toes, we come into plank, and then from here, knees come down, chest and chin. Squeeze your elbows in, lift up, inhale, with just the strength of your back, and exhale down. Extend your arms forward, Lift your arms, lift your legs. Inhale here. Exhale, lower. And inhale. Reach high, chest, thighs off the ground. Exhale, down. And last one. Inhale, reach up. Hold it here, breathe. And exhale, release. Hands right next to your chest. Press into onto all four and into your down dog. Very good. From here, right foot takes a big step forward. Draw your left heel down and reach your hands up. Palms touch. Take a little moment here. Navel in and up. With the inhale, you get a little longer, and on the exhale, you open up. Squeeze your palms together. Open the chest here. And exhale, we come low. Half crown. Try to reach the ground. Inhale, coming straight back up. Reach your hands up. And hands come down. Take a step back. Knees, chest, chin. Inhale, get long. Lift your chest. And lower, tag your toes, and back into your down dog. Your left foot steps forward, your right heel comes down. Inhale, warrior one. Make sure that your knee is right above your left heel. Inhale, make yourself long, and exhale, hands come in the back together. Open up here, squeeze your palms together, arms straight or bent, that's up to you. And on your exhale, bend down, low. Inhale here, exhale here, and coming straight back up, reach your hands up, and exhale, hands come down, take a step back, knees, chest, chin, light, squeeze your elbows in, lift your chest off the ground, exhale, push back into your down dog. Two breaths here, deeply in, deeply out. One more, inhale. One more, exhale. On your next exhalation, you bend your knees and your right foot takes a big step forward. Your left knee comes down, your left glute and inner thigh squeeze. Inhale, reach your hands up. And exhale, hands come down. And we take a step forward. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, hello. Bend your knees, sit into your chair, reach your hands up, navel in, try to relax your shoulders here, and exhale, release. Close your eyes here for a little moment. Take an inhale, take an exhale, navel in and up, quads activated. Shoulders relax down. Breathe in and out through the nose using your ocean whisper breath. Very good. From here, let's sit back down onto the mat. And from here, I will give you two options. So you can have here your knees bend, your feet as wide as your hip, and hands behind you and fingertips pointing towards you. From here, roll your shoulders back. So chest is proud. You press into your feet and lift your hips up towards the ceiling. From here, lift your hip a little higher, and if you like, you can even release your head down if it feels more better for you. You can keep gazing towards your knees. Second option here is you extend your legs and press also from here. We breathe, we hold, inhale here, exhale, lift the hip a little more, and slowly release down. Open the distance in between your feet, pull your toes towards you. Make sure that if you need something to prop your hips up, do so. And then from here, walk forward until you can't anymore. Your back is trying to stay as straight as possible, so we're trying to avoid this, rather with pressing the lower back down, broadening across your collarbones, and then maybe from here we release a little bit more down. Your hands onto the mat, your neck is long, your back is long. You can open your step even more. For me, it's space-wise not possible. If you have more space, open up here and lean forward. Try to keep your chest proud, your neck long, your toes pointing towards you. Inhale deep here, exhale out, inhale here, exhale, maybe release a little bit more into this pose. And the last one. Inhale deeply in and exhale deep out. From here, walk yourself back into seated position, feet together. If you like, a little shake. Very good. And then from here, let's come down to the mat. And knees towards you, your hip comes over on to your left side, and your knees over onto the right side. Your hands can be in cactus arms or in T shape, or one hand onto your knee and one hand in cactus or T shape. And then from here, gaze over towards your left hand side. Make sure that your left shoulder is down onto the mat, even though it means that your knees are off the ground. You can place something underneath your knees and to relax them here. Inhale here. Exhale. Finding a deep, steady breath. Deep inhalations through the nose, into the chest, into the belly. Two more. Deeply in, deeply out. Last one. And slowly, slowly coming back to center. From here, your hip comes over on to your right side and your knees over onto the left side. Also here, make sure your right shoulder is down onto the mat. And relax here. Relax your legs. Shoulders, your hands, all down onto the mat. We go for two more breaths in. Two more breaths out. The last one. And slowly release from here. Make sure you're taking the whole space off your mat. So your feet are as wide as your mat and you lay down here. Tuck your chin in. And your palms are facing up. Close your eyes here. Let's take three breaths here together. Deep in through the nose and exhale out through the mouth. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale deep. Exhale all the air out. And last one, inhale. In through the nose, chest and belly, fill it up. And exhale out. Let your breath come back to natural. Just focus on your body and how you can relax it a little bit more. If you find yourself struggling here to keeping your body still without doing anything, don't worry, absolutely normal. Also, our end relaxation pose requires a little bit of practice. But we'll get better also here with the time. So all good. Just give it a little time and to refocus again on how you can relax your body a little bit more. With the next inhalation, start wiggling your toes, start wiggling your fingertips. Reach your hands up overhead. Any movements that you need here, go for it. And so once you're ready, place one hand onto your heart and one hand onto your belly. And if you like to repeat as quietly or as loud as you wish, you're more than invited to do so. May this yoga practice heal and strengthen my body and my mind. May this yoga practice heal and strengthen your body and your mind. You may stay as long as you wish in your end relaxation pose. I hope you enjoyed today's class and already feel the effects of the class flowing through an easy flow, a slow flow, and opening up in the same time your heart and the parts of your shoulders. Let me know how you feel after the class and have fun practicing and see you back next time in our yoga home. Bye bye.